Good morning students. In my previous video we have discussed the condition of series resonance circuit. Now next today we are taking quality factor. This is also known as sharpness of resonance. And symbolically we can also write it as Q factor. Not symbolically, just short form for this quality factor. Basically, this quality factor, as the term indicates, that it is dealing with quality. That means quality of what? It determines sharpness of tuning at resonance. Sharpening means current, maximum current. So how can we define this quality factor of series resonance circuit? Mathematically, it is taken as the ratio of voltage drop across inductor or voltage drop across capacitor at resonance to the impressed voltage applied across resistor. That means quality factor, it is given by voltage drop across inductor to voltage drop across resistance, or voltage drop across capacitor to the voltage drop across resistor. Either use this result or you can use this result. Both will give the same result. Let me check it. As voltage drop across inductor is XLI and across VR is RI, whereas for VC is XCI. So quality factor is VL upon VR, that is XLI upon RI, where XL is omega L upon R. Now at resonance we have obtained the value of angular frequency. This is equal to 1 by under root of LC. So Q will be equal to 1 by R, and this is L by under root of LC. Here omega, 1 by LC, this L upon R. Right. Now just what we will do, just you can rationalize it. So under root L, under root L. So what you are getting here, this will be one, this is L by R under root L, this will be under root of L square C. When this L square under the root sign, if it is taken outside, this will be L, and we are getting under root of L by C. So quality factor is 1 by R under root of LC. So here we have obtained it by taking the ratio of VL upon VR. Let me also check it for the other formula. Will give the same result. See, this is XCI upon IR or RI. I will be cancelled. XC is your 1 by omega C R. Omega is, we have already taken under root of LC. So it will come in the numerator, divide by RC. So now again rationalizing, you will get the same result as we have obtained this result. Right? So here quality factor, as we have taken, now mathematically its formula comes out to be this one in terms of resistance, inductance and capacitance. This quality factor, it is just a number, it is having no dimension. Why it has no dimension? You can see from here, it is the ratio of voltage drop across capacitor or resistor, inductor and resistor. So this quality factor, it is basically voltage multiplication factor of circuit. Now as resistance increases, we know, as we have just shown this graphical representation, as resistance increases, this maximum current decreases. So as current decreases, you can say this quality factor will also decreases. It means higher the value of quality factor means there will be more sharpness at resonance, that narrower the curve. Here more will be the value of quality factor, more will be the current corresponding to less value of the resistance, and this is indicating narrower and sharpness at the resonance. Basically there is a peak, this is basically indicating higher value of current at the resonance condition. Now quality factor can also be defined in terms of bandwidth. See, as we have plotted this curve, this is the peak maximum value of current at resonance frequency. Now if we take sideband frequency, we have to take those value of side bend frequency. There is one particular condition at which current is, this is the maximum value of current, current become 1 by under root 2 times the maximum value of current. So side bend frequency, this is lower side band, this is upper side band. This lower side band and upper side band, these are the frequencies at which current amplitude is 1 by under root 2 times the maximum value of current. So what does this omega 1, that is representing, this is omega r, yani minus delta v. यानी इससे कुछ वैल्यू लेस है, लेट इट इज लेस बाय फैक्टर डेल ओमेगा. सिमिलरली ओमेगा टू अपर साइड फ्रीक्वेंसी, दिस इज ओमेगा आर प्लस डेल ओमेगा. नाउ व्हाई वी आर डूइंग ऑल दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन, बिकॉज वी वांट टू डिफाइन दिस क्वालिटी फैक्टर इन टर्म्स ऑफ बैंडविड्थ. सो नाउ हियर व्हाट इज द बैंडविड्थ, बैंडविड्थ it is basically taken as omega 2 minus omega 1, this is 2 del omega. So now quality factor of resonance circuit, it is the ratio of angular resonance frequency to the bandwidth. So this bandwidth is your, you can take it, this is 2 del, just a minute, this omega 2 minus omega 1, this should be, this is omega r plus del omega minus omega r minus minus plus del omega. So now you can see it is 2 del omega, this is 2 del omega. So this is bandwidth. So quality factor in another way can be defined in terms of resonant frequency, resonant angular frequency and bandwidth. See, quality factor concept will be used in mathematically in numerical part. So there are two formulas, one in terms of voltage drop, from there you have calculated the result in terms of inductor, capacitor and resistance, and another in terms of bandwidth. So now we will do few numericals on this basis while doing the numerical section, then we will utilize such statements, such formulas. Now next is average power associated with LCR circuit. See, what will be the power when we are taking the complete combination of all the three components. Let, for this combination we are applying alternating EMF, this is E equal to E naught sin omega t. As we know here, current change, current have some phase relationship in case of this circuit. So current lags behind or current leads the EMF by some angle. Here we are taking one specific condition, let the current lag behind the EMF by angle phi. It's not compulsory, you can take omega t plus phi, it can be, that is current is leading, as I am taking here I equal to I naught sin omega t minus phi. That means current can lag, because in case of inductor and capacitor, either the current is lagging or leading the EMF. So any condition you can take. So basically for this circuit I am taking these two conditions, you can take these two also, result will be obtained in a similar way. Now power. Power is rate of doing work, this is given by E into I. So this is all mathematical step, so we have to follow all the steps. E equal to E naught sin omega t, I is I naught sin omega t minus phi. So it will be E naught I naught sin omega t minus phi. Now it will be E naught I naught sin omega t, then sin omega t minus phi. Here you will use the result sin a minus b. What is the result of sin a minus b? Let me write it here. Sin a minus b is sin a cos b minus sin b cos a. Same you will apply here. It will be sin omega t cos phi minus cos omega t sin phi. So now after this, this is E naught I naught. Now multiply these terms. So now sin square omega t cos phi minus E naught I naught. Here this sin omega t will be multiplied with this term, sin omega t cos omega t and sin phi. So now Here, if we multiply this expression by 2 and divide by 2, so what is the purpose of it? Because 2 sine omega t cos omega t, we can write it as sine 2 omega t. So directly, that's why I have multiplied and divide by 2, because it will not make any difference. So now dw, this is equal to, that is dw upon dt, so rate of doing work. Now here dt will be multiplied and you will use this formula. It will be e naught I naught sine square omega t cos phi minus e naught I naught by 2. This 2 will be combined with this sine omega t cos phi. This will be sine 2 omega t sine phi. This is your sine 2 omega t and this is your sine phi. And this is multiplied by dt. Now, if you want to obtain total work done, what should you do? You should integrate this within the limit, that is from 0 to t. So it will be e naught I naught sine square omega t cos phi minus e naught I naught by 2 sine 2 omega t sine phi right by dt. So you will just integrate this and this term, because e naught I naught and cos phi, this will be treated as a constant. So in the next step, I will take this constant factor outside the integration sign. 0 to t sine square omega t and this dt I am combining here. For second term also, e naught I naught by 2 sine phi 0 to t sine 2 omega t dt. So here, now I am not solving this, because you know in maths you have studied, if you will integrate it by expanding it, the result I am taking directly, this will be e naught I naught cos phi and its value is t by 2. How? You can say, you can just convert it in terms of 1 minus cos omega t upon 2. So you will use it. I am not explaining it here. Just use maths result, because you have done in the maths integration part. Similarly, when you will integrate this part, the result comes out to be 0. So total work done, that comes out to be this one. But what we have to calculate here, we are calculating average power associated with the circuit. So average power will be, power is rate of doing work. So now here, if you will take this t here, so w upon t will be, mathematically if you will simplify it, this is e naught I naught cos phi by 2. Now we can convert it into one form, e naught by root 2 I naught by root 2 into cos phi. This is virtual EMF, this is virtual current. So EV IV cos phi, this result we are getting. This is average power associated with LCR circuit, where EV is the virtual value or RMS value of EMF. Similarly, IV is the virtual value of current. Now, actually we can calculate this average power associated with pure resistive circuit, pure capacitor circuit, pure inductive circuit. Now if you have calculated this result for the combination, after this we can just use special condition and directly come to the conclusion. So now for resistive circuit, as voltage and current are in same phase, so phi will be 0 degree. So average power will be EV IV. So power, average power associated with pure resistive circuit will be EV into IV. But for inductor, you can say inductive or capacitive circuit, right? So for that, there is either a phase difference, there is a phase difference of 90 degree or pi by 2. It means, in any of the component, either the current is leading the voltage or lagging the voltage, but the difference, but that phase difference is of 90 degree each. Na? So in that particular case, we can say that for any pure inductive circuit or capacitive circuit, when phi is 90 degree, cos phi will be 0. Cos 90 0. So average power associated with pure inductive and capacitive circuit is 0. This is an important conclusion. Sometimes to confuse, many a times this can be asked, this can be used in conceptual problems directly. So you can use the result also. So this is all derivation parts we have covered. Now we are taking few numericals on its basis. Now the next numericals we are taking on AC circuits. When a circuit element X, it is connected across an AC source, a current of root 2 ampere flows through it, and this current is in phase with the applied voltage. This current is in phase with the applied voltage. This means now you get one information from this point. When another element Y is connected across the same AC source. Another element Y is connected across the same source, same current flows in the circuit. Now, but it leads the voltage by pi by 2 radian. So now, here as the current leads the voltage and current is in phase with the voltage, two very important information has been given. You can identify the circuit elements X and Y. First part is this one, identify or name the circuit elements X and Y. Second part, find the current that flows in the circuit when series combination of X and Y is connected across AC voltage. And finally, plot a graph showing variation of net impedance of this series combination of X and Y as a function of angular frequency of applied voltage. See, statement seems to be lengthy, but don't get confused with the lengthy statement. Just have complete information. On this basis, try to get the result of each and every question which has been asked. So see, as per the statement, first of all, you have to identify X and Y as current of under root 2 ampere is flowing. For X, current and voltage are in phase. That means when they are in phase, then X is a resistor. Because for the resistor, there is no phase difference between current and voltage. Now coming to the second information given. Here it has been asked, it has been given that same current flows in a circuit, but that means circuit when Y is connected. But here current leads the voltage by 90 radian. So current is leading the voltage by 90 degree. What does it mean? It means Y will be capacitor. How can we relate it? See, in LCR circuit, I have discussed this particular point. This is a standard direction of current, and in capacitor, current is leading the voltage. In inductor, current is lagging the voltage. So in that particular case, from this phase diagram, you come to know that which component we are taking. Because confusion lie here only in this point. Either current lag or lead. So capacitor ko hum niche dikha rahe hain, to hum kahenge ki current isme lag kar, lead kar raha hai, sorry, current lead kar raha hai, current aage aa raha hai, so current is leading. So that's why Y is a capacitor. Now in the second part, what has been asked? Find current that flows in a circuit when this capacitor and resistor are connected in series to an AC source. When these are connected in AC source, so first of all, what will be the impedance? This will be XC square plus R square. This will be XC square plus RC square. Sorry, R square. See the statement. Statement mein kya kaha hai aapko? When another element Y is connected across the same AC voltage, yani कैपेसिटर के क्रॉस एंड रजिस्टर के क्रॉस वोल्टेज सेम लगाई है और जिसमें करंट भी सेम फ्लो हुआ है. तो व्हाट इंफॉर्मेशन वी आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम हेयर? वी आर गेटिंग दैट XC इक्वल टू R. अब XC इक्वल टू R है, सो सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू हेयर. Z विल बी अंडर रूट ऑफ R स्क्वेयर. XC की वैल्यू R, अंडर रूट ऑफ R स्क्वेयर प्लस R स्क्वेयर, दिस इज अंडर रूट ऑफ 2R. राइट? सो नाउ what you have to calculate? Current flowing through this series combination. Series mein current same flow hoga. So current will be equal to, this is V upon, this is Z. Now what is the value of V here? See, as V R will be equal to VC, so it is I into R or I into XC. Now I given kitna hai? Under root of 2. under root 2r. Here also it will be under root of 2xc, which is under root of 2r. So effective EMF that comes out to be under root of 2r. So bataiye current kitna hoga. This is V upon Z. Z is this one. So here it is, comes out to be 1 ampere. See, steps are simple. Just you have to think that what step we are following, in what way we have to proceed. Now in the third part, we have to show a variation of impedance, net impedance, for this series combination of X and Y with angular frequency. So it will be like this. So now next numerical. A resistor of 200 ohm and a capacitor of 15 microfarad are connected in series to 220 volt and 50 hertz AC source. Now what we have to do, calculate current in the circuit. So series combination है capacitor and resistor का, जैसा हमने पिछले केस में लिया है, अब उसमें current निकालना है. Calculate voltage, that means RMS value of voltage across resistor as well as across capacitor. Is the algebraic sum of these voltages more than the source voltage? If yes, resolve this paradox. This is very important kind of numerical. See, don't get confused with the statement. The statement is quite simple. बस हमें अलग अलग करके हर पॉइंट को जज करना है कि कैसे निकालना है. सबसे पहले हमें सर्किट में रजिस्टर और कैपेसिटर सीरीज कॉम्बिनेशन में दिए हुए हैं, जिसमें वोल्टेज गिवन है. इनका इम्पिडेंस निकाल के हम सर्किट में करंट निकाल सकते हैं. फिर उसके बाद हमें दोनों कंपोनेंट के अक्रॉस RMS वोल्टेज निकालनी है. अब हमें बताना है जो थर्ड पार्ट जो सबसे इम्पॉर्टेंट है कि एल्जेब्रिक सम ऑफ दीज वोल्टेज इज मोर देन द सोर्स वोल्टेज. ऐसा है? अगर ऐसा है तो इसमें प्रॉब्लम क्या है, क्या क्या इसमें पैराडॉक्स है, किस कॉन्सेप्ट के बेसिस पर हम ये बात कह रहे हैं, व्हाट इज द राइट पॉइंट इन दिस. लेट्स सी हाउ वी विल अंडरस्टैंड इट. सी हियर, रेजिस्टेंस ऑफ द गिवन रजिस्टर इज 200 ओम एंड कैपेसिटेंस इज 15 माइक्रोफैरेड. दैट कैन बी रिटन एज 15 इंटू 10 टू द पावर -6 फैरेड. एंड given value of voltage, that is supplied voltage, again this is RMS, it's not peak. Supplied voltage is always RMS and its frequency is 50 hertz. These are given informations. So now you have to calculate current through the circuit. So first of all, for current we require impedance, that is under root of R square plus XC square. So XC need to be calculated. XC is 1 by 2 pi nu into C. All the factors have been given. If we will substitute the values, then you can solve the value and I will check the answer. I will just putting the final answer of it because I have done the calculations. So it is 212.3 ohm. Now I will put this value here because R is given. So calculate Z from here. R is 200 and X is 212.3. so when you will solve it again, it will come out to be 291.5. so simply here calculation is slightly lengthy, otherwise steps you can see it's quite simple. So what will be the current? RMS value of current will be VRMS given, that is 220 upon Z. So 220 upon 291.5, this is 0.755 ampere. तो दिस इज द फर्स्ट स्टेप, करंट हमने निकाल लिए. अब क्या बोला है, हमें दोनों रजिस्टर और कैपेसिटर दोनों के अक्रॉस RMS वैल्यू निकालनी है. तो वी आर एम एस अक्रॉस रजिस्टर, इट विल बी आई आर एम एस इंटू आर. अब ये क्या है, 0.755 मल्टीप्लाइड बाई रजिस्टेंस 200. जब आप इसे सॉल्व करते हैं, इट इज़ 151 वोल्ट. एंड वी अक्रॉस, यानी आर एम एस वैल्यू ऑफ वोल्टेज अक्रॉस कैपेसिटर, इट इज़ वी, दिस इज आई आर एम एस इंटू एक्स सी. सो इट इज़ योर 0.755 इंटू 212.3, दिस इज 160.3 वोल्ट. नाउ द थर्ड पार्ट, दैट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इज अलजेब्रिक सम ऑफ दीज टू वोल्टेज इज ग्रेटर देन सोर्स. लेट मी चेक, वी आर प्लस वी सी, दिस कम्स आउट टू बी 151 plus 160.3. so it comes out to be here 300, this is 3 point, this is 111.3. but what is the given value? Given value is 220 volt. So how is difference arises? See, actually there is a big point which you have to understand. Just make it a star, make it a point that you have to focus. Here basically, in case of resistance, there is no phase relationship between current and EMF, but in capacitor there exists some phase relationship. There is some phase difference. So जब हम इसका phasor diagram बनाते हैं तो उस phasor diagram में हम कैसे दिखाते हैं VR इधर और VC इधर, तो इन दोनों का जो resultant आता है that is that V is under root of VR square plus VC square. यानी हम Pythagoras apply कर रहे हैं यहाँ पर, यहाँ directly algebraics हम apply नहीं होगा. अब अगर आप इन दोनों values को VR और VC को यहाँ substitute करते हैं then you will solve, you will get the result will be 220 volt. So you will say that algebraic sum will be definitely greater than this value. Why? Because we are not adding it according to the phase relationship between the given quantities, between resistance and the capacitance. This is an important point which you have to understand. This is the question which has been asked in the board exams also. So be focused about it. Coming to next numerical. State the condition under which the phenomena of resonance occur in series LCR circuit. I hope this is clear to you now, that at what condition resonance occur. Here it should be that inductive reactance must be equal to capacitive reactance. Now further plot a graph showing variation of current with frequency of AC source in series LCR circuit. This means you have to plot current with frequency under this resonance condition. Mention the factor on which resonance frequency of series LCR circuit depends. Now how to solve it? So I have just taken the main point that up to this one, as this is a statement. Now coming to its solution part. So resonance occur when XL equal to XC. That means when inductive reactance equal to capacitive reactance. Now if you have to plot graph, this the topic we have done, that when current is plotted with the frequency, either angular frequency or normal frequency, you will plot, the graph will be this. So this will be the peak value of current at resonance frequency. So resonance frequency as omega is equal to 1 by under root of LC, and frequency will be here 2 pi under root of LC. Now they are asking about the point that mention the factor on which resonance frequency of series LCR circuit depend. Now you can see here it depend upon this inductance and capacitance. So this resonance frequency depend upon the value of inductance and capacitance. So it's quite simple question. There is no much point that has to be different from the, as compared to the topics we have covered. Now see next question. You can say it to be a conceptual question. For a series LCR circuit connected to sinusoidal AC voltage source, identify the graph that corresponds to omega greater than under root of LC and give reason also. Here two graphs have been plotted here, and out of these two identify the graph that correspond to the condition omega greater than under root of LC. Now see here, condition is omega under root greater than under root of LC. When omega is greater than this, it means this XL must be greater than XC. So what does it indicate? That the circuit that correspond to, that is inductive circuit, that means domination of the inductor factor. When XL is greater than XC, then inductor having the dominating effect, so the circuit will be inductive. Now here, out of these two graphs are between voltage and current, showing the relationship between, this is for voltage and current in both the graphs. Now identify for this particular condition, basically this particular condition, which graph corresponds. Now just check the results. In inductor, voltage leads the current. Now see, in which case voltage is leading the current? Here voltage is leading the current in this graph A, right? Here we are taking that here in the condition where its maxima is there, voltage is maxima and the EMF current is minimum. So A graph correspond to the condition omega greater than under root 1 by under root of LC. Now Let me take one more numerical. This will be the last numerical for today. Three students XYZ performed an experiment for studying variation of alternating current with angular frequency in series LCR circuit. Three students have performed the experiment and studied the variation of current with the frequency. Now obtain the graph. Here the graphical representation has been shown. Here you can see that for X, Y and Z the peak value of current is going on decreasing. This is also a peak. Now they all used AC sources of same RMS value and in inductances of same value. Same inductance they have used and same AC value has been given. What can we conclude about capacitive values, resistance values? Now from this graph you have to get conclusion about capacitive values and resistance value from this graph used by them. In which case will the quality factor be maximum and what can we conclude about nature of impedance of the setup at frequency omega naught, that is resonant frequency. So the question seems to be quite lengthy, but the step by step you have to just go through what has been asked, then only you can simplify it. Let's see how to understand it. So here as per the graph we know that omega naught, that is resonant frequency, is same. So it means, as we know, omega equal to 1 by under root of LC. It has been given that all these are using same AC sources as well as inductances. That means this L is same, used by the three. So if omega naught, this is same, this is the resonant frequency. So if Lx will be equal to Ly equal to Lz, that means X, Y, Z use the same value of inductor. So if omega naught is same, resonant frequency is same, what we can conclude about capacitance? We will say that Cx will be equal to Cy equal to Cz. It means what have been asked in the question, what can we conclude about capacitive values? So capacitive values will also be same, reason being at resonant frequency here XL inductance has been given to be same, so automatically capacitive value will be same as used by the three. Now we know that current is given by E naught by R, that means current is inversely proportional to R. As from the graph what we can observe, that current is maximum as observed by X, then by Y, then by Z. So peak value of current, that is by X, is greater than that of Y and that of Z. So if our resistance is inversely proportional to current, no need to explain that resistance of X will be less than that of Y and it is less than that of Z. And another point they have been asking, that quality factor maximum kis case mein hoga? Quality factor inversely proportional hota hai resistance ke. Directly bhi likh sakte hai, right? So when it is inversely proportional to resistance, it means jitna resistance kam hoga usi case mein quality factor zyada hoga. To ultimately wo kaun sa case hoga? Jis case mein current ki value maximum hogi. So quality factor will be more maximum for X than Y and then Z. So this was about quality factor. Next was, what can we conclude about nature of impedance at the setup? See, at resonance, basically we are talking about resonant frequency. So at resonance we can say XL equal to XC. It means that Z equal to R. Why? Because when this is equal, both these values are equal, their difference will be zero. So what we conclude, the circuit will be resistive. So here in LCR circuit the dominance will be of resistance, because here inductive capacitance is equal to inductive reactance is equal to capacitive reactance. So a circuit will be resistance dominating. So that's all for today. Although we have covered different numericals, but now you will practice more numerical on this basis. If you face any doubt, any problem in doing any numerical, just you can ask anytime. Thank you. Have a nice day.